How do you choose which PDO thread to use? There's so many brands, many people are confused. Let's talk about it today. So PDO threads are a craze around the nation. And when you go to conferences, there was one or two providers of threads within the country maybe 5 years ago. Now it's not uncommon to see 8 to 12 vendors of threads in this country. And just about every morning when people wake up and check their inbox and their email, there's a thread company from overseas or an unknown country offering threads at a certain price, different threads, different molded threads, barbed threads, hurricane threads, all these different threads. How is a provider to choose? And a lot of people ask me commonly, which threads do you use? How should I decide? What about cost? Let's tackle a cost issue first because it's an important factor in your outcome. However, the outcome that you get is based on the person doing the treatment, looking at the vectors, determining the best placement of the threads, the depth, and the amount of barbed or molded threads to smooth threads, and the concomitant treatments. So the price of the thread should be a very small factor for a provider to decide what thread they're using. It's much more important to pick something that's safe. Safety first, and what's going to give you the best outcome, because side effects like puckering, thread visibility, not getting the right amount of lift, a short duration, are all issues that are much more important than the cost of the thread and should be considered. What are the five things that I think you should look for in choosing a company for your threads? The first one is, how long has the company been around? There are so many companies that come and go that try and provide trainings for their threads, but don't consistently have an avenue for feedback, for development of the threads, and for training. So pick a company that's been around a long time. Number two, I think it's nice to have a company that's FDA cleared. I think it gives some reassurance to the provider and the patients, so it's something good to look at. The third would be an indicator on the thread that shows bevel up or bevel down, particularly for barbed and molded threads. So new molded threads should be placed slightly deeper, or at least at the perfect depth where the barbed threads can be placed. The barbed threads you can get away with a little more superficial. The molded threads, I think knowing where the bevel is very important to get great outcomes in my experience in the trainings we've done so far on these molded threads. It's a whole another level of results we're getting with them. The fourth important factor is if they're made in this country. And I think it doesn't exclude them. It doesn't mean other threads are bad, but I think there's some reassurance to our patients, to ourselves, that we know where they're being made. And of course, I'm referring to sterility. If you know and you're comfortable where your threads are being made and they're FDA cleared and you feel good with the process of how they're made and how clean they are and how consistently they are, because sometimes if you order some threads, depending on the source, the threads can be perfect in one batch, the second batch can be very different. It's your patient, it's your outcome, and ultimately they're not going to blame the thread as much as they are the person who put it in. So I think made in the United States is a very key factor to look for, in my opinion, for me. The fifth consideration are the threads that are available. I use a lot more smooth than barb, but I do like a 21 gauge, an 18 gauge, and of course the new molded, and I use the molded infinities, are absolutely amazing. We're getting just way better results. We're getting more lift. We're getting longer duration so far. They're a little more particular to put in, but that gives me a range. I can use a smaller thread in someone who's had a facelift or Sculptra or Bellafill or collagen stimulators. I can use a larger thread in those who want to be more aggressive and get more lift. And I can use in between. Also for the body, a lot of times if you only have 1.5 or 1 inch threads, it's cumbersome. You have to put too many threads in. Having a nice 2.5 inch smooth and twist is really nice for the body if you're doing body threads. So I think those are five factors that you can consider at least when you choose the threads that you use. Keep in mind, it's an art. And when we're doing threads, like every other aesthetic procedure, your provider is looking at the results as we go. Because it's not a surgical procedure, someone's lying back, the surgery's done, you get up, you have the result. The beauty of minimally invasive treatments are you can look. If you put a barbed thread in, you get a great amount of lift, you might put one more in or you might hold off. If you don't get the lift you want, you might say, well, I'm gonna go up and use an infinity molded thread, I need more lift. So it's a continuum. Let us know what threads are you using, what do you like? Pop over to Instagram. We talk about many topics on PDO threads and facial rejuvenation over there. Subscribe here and join me for continued helpful tips. Keep your skin and body beautiful, healthy, and vibrant.